So now we are going to do how to add comments or notes in an Excel sheet. First of all, जब हम लोग कुछ भी एक बड़े डेटा सेट को लेके उस पर काम कर रहे हैं, सो इट इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट वी एक्सप्लेन इट इन अ बेटर वे, इन अ यूज़र फ्रेंडली वे टू हूम एवर वी वॉन्ट टू कम्युनिकेट द टेबल्स और मे बी आर एनालिसिस. सो इट्स बेटर दैट वी यूज़ कमेंट्स एंड नोट्स इन आर एक्सेल. So that people who are using our Excel know that what we have done and what how we have calculated, how we have come to the conclusion. So for that, there are many different ways to do that. सबसे पहला चीज़ जो हम लोग करते हैं, that is to add a text box. Now how to add a text box is very, it's very easy. Insert tab में जाओ. Insert tab में you'll see text box का option. Just click on the text box. And you can just simply insert your text box and add your comment over here. Simply your add comment over here. And simply wherever you want to place this chart, be it in your graphs, which we learn later on in the course, be it in your graphs, be it anywhere you want to, you can just simply adjust the size of this particular text box and you can add it anywhere you want to. So the first method is to add a text box. Now the other ways in which you can add comments is a very, very useful and very widely used. Generally, we all use these types of comments. So it's basically it adds comment to a particular cell. Now how to do that? Now suppose this is a small data set which I have. These are the regions. These are the quantity sold, amount, total, which I have just simply multiplied the quantity with amount, and this is the gross profit. Now gross profit is calculated as amount into 0.6, yani ki 60% of the amount is what my gross profit is coming. So isko hum log kya kar sakte hain? Now let's say we need to tell the reason to whomever we are presenting this, that why we have multiplied 60%. Or from where the 60% is coming. Simply what you need to do is, simply you will go to the review tab. Review tab mein there is a new comment section. New comments section. Just simply click on the new comment. And new comment pe click karte. When you are in this particular cell, new comment pe click karte, there is a dialog box. And this is the Dell, this is the username which I have inputted over here. Aapka jo bhi laptop mein username hoga, wo idhar aa jayega. So this, and then simply if you want to delete it, there's not an issue. You can just simply go and delete this. And whatever you want to give the reason for using 60% as your margin. So this is what you can do by simply adding a comment. Now what is the benefit of adding a comment? Simply when I take my cursor on the cell, you can see this red flag over here. This red flag signifies that there is a comment on this particular cell. I'll just take my cursor on the cell. I'll just hover. Isko hum log kya bolte hain? That this red flag denotes a comment. Kabhi bhulna mat. Red flag ka matlab nahi error hai. Green flag ka matlab hota hai error, and which is on the left side. Red flag on the right side signifies a comment. And you can just take your cursor on the cell. And you can see that whatever comments you have mentioned, in that particular comment box it appears. This is one thing. Next, in the comment section, what you can do is, you can simply show all comments. Isse kya hoga? Jitni bhi sheet mein jitni bhi comments hai na, wo yahan pe you can simply see all the comments together. Let's just suppose I'm adding one more comment over here. Simply I'll click on new comment and I'll write term quantity into amount. Just a simple explanation, and I'll just left click on any other cell. As soon as you click on show all comments, isse kya hoga dekho, jitne bhi sare text box honge wo apne aap open ho jayenge in your particular Excel sheet, jitne bhi sare honge in that particular sheet. Theek hai? So again I'll just click on show all comments. Obviously you can click next. इससे क्या होगा, जो भी आपके कमेंट्स आपने जिस ऑर्डर में मेंशन किए वो आते रहेंगे, एंड इफ़ यू वांट टू डिलीट अ कमेंट यू कैन जस्ट सिंपली क्लिक ऑन डिलीट और सिंपली एडिट इफ़ यू वांट टू एडिट द कमेंट दैट पर्टिकुलर कमेंट. दिस इज़ हाउ, दिस इज़ अ वेरी वेरी वाइडली यूज्ड फीचर विच वी जनरली प्रेफर यूजिंग वेन वेवर वी वॉन्ट टू प्रेजेंट एनी डेटा टू द outsider, and you know they just simply click on show all comments and just go through all the comments which we have mentioned. Or this red flag is a significance that yes, we have added a comment on this particular cell. And the short and this is how just we added a comment. Also there is a shortcut to add a comment. Shortcut is given by shift plus F2. So simply clicking shift plus F2 on any cell, the comment box opens up and you can just simply add a comment. Suppose I am adding a comment over here, simply I'll click shift F2 and the dialog box, comment box opens up. If by pressing shift F2 you cannot open the dialog box, you'll have to press shift FN F2. Shift FN, FN is the function key, shift FN F2 and the dialog box for the comment open ups and you can simply add a comment over here. So it's very simple and it's very interesting how to add comments in the Excel. The next way in which we can add comments is can simply copy this down over here in your copy so that it's better for your future purposes. And then we have the N function. In this particular thing, this is not so widely used and generally it might not used in Excel. Basically we use it when we want to connect different worksheets or workbooks and spreadsheets. Generally we don't use it always. So what are the uses of N function? N function annotates formulas in your worksheet. Now suppose you have inputted or written a very big formula or a function in your cell and you want to explain it to the examiner as to why you have written that particular formula. So simply N signifies your function and N, and you can simply in quotations you can write your comment over here. And whenever you write a comment over here with a plus sign with any other function, it just reverts a zero value so that it doesn't affect your formula. For example, I've just written over here B2, which is a cell name, into 0.8. So this is my function, this is my core function. I've simply added the N comment, which is plus with a plus sign N, and I've written we used 0.85 as per the instructions in quotations. So writing this particular thing, this particular function in your cell, in your formula, will not change this particular formula and your answer will remain same. This whole thing will revert, will give an outcome of zero. So just see, I've made a list of what all input values you can give in N and what is the return or the output value which you'll get. So if you specify any other value, suppose within N you write any of the numerical or additive operators or any of that, it will return you the same value. Suppose I have written 6 plus 5, so it will return you 11. So it will return you the same value. If it is, if you have written true, it will return you 1. If you are writing false, it will return you 0. And if there is an error, then the same error code, suppose I am dividing any number by 0, so the same div by 0 error code will appear. And any other value you mention, you'll get a 0. So we'll just look on the examples. Suppose this was my calculation which I had done. I had taken the total amount and I had multiplied it with 0.6. Simply I'll add the N comment over here. As you can see, it converts the non-number value to a number, dates to serial numbers, true to 1, anything else to 0. So I'll just simply write 0.6. Don't forget to mention it in quotations. Why? Because then Excel knows that you are writing something which is a text string. So that Excel returns zero for that. If you don't use the quotations, then an error will appear. So you'll always have to use quotations to tell Excel that you are writing certain text string in your function. 0.6 used as per instructions. So just I'll close the bracket and you can just see nothing has changed. The formula remains the same. The answer remains the same. Just that this particular comment will let other people who use your Excel to understand that why you have multiplied your function with 0.6. So it's also a way you can add comments to your formulas. So this is how, and then we saw how using n function will just simply I'll show you n, and mentioning the true value will give you 1, mentioning false will give you 0, mentioning any other thing, suppose any other value, suppose I have written just 8, it will give you 8. I have written 8 plus 2, it will give you 10. Or mentioning any other value, simply I have just written text, I have written my name without using quotations, it will give you a name error, obviously, because it will not recognize that what you have written within the function. Or else if I undertake any erroneous calculation, suppose 4 by 0, so it will give you an div by 0 error. So basically we rarely use this function, and generally we use it with other spreadsheets when we want to connect the spreadsheet. The most famous way of adding comment is this way of adding comments to your cells. Just copy this down so that you know it's better for your future purposes. Thank you.